Are you tired of those generic channel point rewards? Well, today I'm going to show you how to spice things up with a free app that you can download, install, and have your viewers control things that are on your stream with a click of a button. Let's get started. Okay, cheesy plug, darkencyrus.com. Before we get into anything, I want to say thank you for all the support that you show my channel and seeing all of the guides that I'm doing to increase your streaming experience for your viewers. If you haven't already, or if you're new to the channel, I'm Cyrus and I make a whole bunch of videos on how to improve your stream by giving you a bunch of different options that are free for you to make the experience for your viewer so much better. So if you want to, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss a video and ring that bell for notifications so that you're able to see when I upload my videos. Make sure you hit a thumbs up because it really helps out the channel. Also, I stream 3 days a week on Twitch, so make sure to go and check me out over there, as well as join the Darkness Discord, where we have a group of streamers and a community of people that'll rally around you and help you build your channel, but also answer any questions that you might have. With that out of the way, let's get started. So what I'm going to be showing you today is an app called Lioranboard, and I was shown this by a YouTuber by the name of Nutty, and he's a fantastic YouTuber, and I love his guides and everything that he does. But what we're going to do today is I'm going to show you what I've done for it and what I use in my stream, because it's kind of unique on what I do to allow my mods to be able to switch my scenes for me and to have a couple of custom channel point rewards that I hope to expand on, but I figured I'd share this with you. So I'm gonna take you into the PC, I'm gonna show you where to get everything, how to install it, and how to put it in so that you can get started on this. So let's go. So right now we're in my PC and we're looking at a couple things that you need to download so this will work. Number one, you're gonna need the OBS WebSocket. A link for that will be in the description below. You need to make sure that that's installed. You're also gonna need to download the Lioranboard Stream Deck Animator. It's completely free. Again, the link will be in the description. And if you want to have some of the customization you're gonna see, you're gonna also want to download Stream FX for OBS Studio. Now, all of you people who are still using Streamlabs OBS, this doesn't work for that. And you can roast me in the comments, but we're gonna keep pushing OBS here. So once you've gotten all of that downloaded, you're going to extract the folder for Lioranboard, and you're gonna go ahead and install the Lioranboard receiver, not the Stream Deck or the Stream Deck for the PC, none of that. You're just gonna install the receiver. You could install the other ones if you need a Stream Deck, but if you don't and you wanna have some kind of an Android option, I have another video. I think it's up this direction. Go ahead and click the I. I just did one where it's a free Android app that is absolutely wonderful. So what you're gonna do is click into the receiver folder and install the receiver so that you can get started with this. If you haven't already, go ahead and install the WebSocket as well as the StreamFX so that you can do the next steps for this. Next, we're gonna boot Lioranboard, the receiver, once you have it. And you can see that mine's already connecting to everything. I wanna make sure that you get yours set up. One of the things you're gonna need to do is connect this to OBS by putting a browser file into your OBS. And it's pretty simple. I'll show you how to do that. In some scene anywhere, it doesn't matter wherever it is, but it has to be in a scene on your current collection. I think mine's under cam or something like that. But what you're going to do is do plus and add a browser. And we're just going to name this the TSL transmitter. And you want to click local file, browse, and then you want to navigate to that folder. It's going to take me a second to actually get to it. And when you get to that folder, you're actually going to see a file called the TSL transmitter. Now the program says TLS transmitter and they're completely conflicting names, but this is what you're going to do. So you're going to click that and click open. And once you've done that, you'll hit okay. And then all you have to do is hide that browser source. Now this browser source doesn't have to be active anywhere on your OBS. It just has to be inside one of them and you can turn it off. Once that's done, you need to make sure that you link your Twitch and connect to Twitch. It's also gonna ask you to make sure that your WebSocket is connected, and if you've had a password on it, make sure you put that password in there. If you don't know how to find that, in OBS, under Tools, you'll see WebSocket Server Settings. I do have a password under Authentication. I just made sure to put that into Lioranboard so I can get access. Now, a couple things that we want to do in Lioranboard is we're going to make a new deck. And you can see that I've got a couple of them here where I've been testing this out. It's screaming at me because I put a second TLS transmitter or TSL transmitter in here. I'm going to delete that one. But what we're going to do is make some decks. Like here's a brand new deck, and you're going to see that this one's completely empty and I can type a brand new button. But I'm going to show you the one that I'm working on right now, which only has four things in it. But my goal is to expand. But for now, we're sitting on four things. I have a dance party emote where it actually flexes my cam and does a sound in the background and does some like RGB lighting over the top of it, and people redeem it for 3,500 channel points. I have one where you can end my stream for 100,000 channel points. And then I have some moderator ones where it changes my scene to live or changes my scene to intermission. And I like to call those big game little face is my live, and then big face little game is intermission. And so they will change it for me if I happen to forget. And all I have to do is in my chat type dash live or dash intermission, and it does it for me. I'm going to show you how I set these up so that you can take care of that. So what you'll do is when you're creating one, you'll hit create new button and just type a button like this one's just called test, and you'll choose add commands. And if you've linked OBS, when you click plus, you're going to see all of these options like scene switch, source mute, source toggle, source change visibility, position, volume, scale, rotation, settings. You can make them spin, move. But one of the best things about this is where you're able to adjust the filters. So you're able to say, I want to change the visibility of this filter and move it or whatever the case. That's why this is so great. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how in my dance party one here, edit commands, you can see that for my camera, I'm actually doing the filter that I've put on there to pulse, do an RGB lights, and it launches a song, which is just a short 6 second clip. And then after those 6,000 or 6 seconds, which is 6,000 milliseconds, I will tell it to filter change and turn it back off. So it will undo those things from my camera. Now I do something called source mirroring. And what that means is I actually have my camera in its own scene by itself. And then when I want to put my camera inside one of my other sources, I don't actually add the camera through like webcam input. I just source mirror right here. You'll see source mirror 2.2. That's actually a mirror of my cam scene. So all of my filters that I have on my camera are in the cam scene. And when somebody activates that channel point, regardless of where I am on anywhere in my stream, whether I'm in intermission or in live, it will make the adjustments to my camera because it's all editing it as a source mirror from an old scene. That might be confusing, and if you want to know more about that, type down in the comments below. Maybe I can do a video talking about source mirrors and how that works. If you don't understand what that means, then go for it and do that. So when somebody actually does this, I'll go ahead and make this big. I'm going to redeem on my screen the dance party so you can see what it looks like. And so that's what happens on my screen. It's real quick, 6 seconds, fades out, it's done. And it looks the same as if I switched over to my intermission screen. It's going to look a little weird, but if I redeemed it here as well, I haven't changed anything except transition over here. Not guide the raid. Let's click dance party, redeem. It's the exact same thing. As you can see, it does the exact same filters. And this is just a stream effects filter. So it's not hard to make those changes and to do so. So there's the options are unlimited. To make it work on channel points, there's two things you need to know. You need to right click and do edit Twitch triggers. And this is where you're able to say you want to redeem for points. You have point redeems, and then you choose a name for it. And this name has to be identical for what you put in Twitch. And I'll show you my setup right now. So I have it named as dance party in my Twitch dashboard. When I go and actually edit and look at those, you'll see that I have it named as Dance Party. I go under Community, Channel Points, Manage Rewards. I have it named Dance Party, even with the exclamation point. And then I just gave it a cost. And so when somebody redeems that, the Lioranboard will receive that information and then activate all of the macros that it's listed there, kind of like a Stream Deck, to give the viewer that opportunity to edit the raid or edit the stream. And then for like change to live, it's the exact same thing. I've done the trigger is just chat, and you can actually limit it to the broadcaster, or in this case, the mod, or whoever. You can make your subs have a special thing that does it into your stream, or just anyone at all can make a change on your stream or whatever you want to do. But I have it just for my mods to be able to switch me to a live scene. As you see, they can type dash live, and then for the edit command, it'll just scene switch me to my live scene. So these are just a few ways on how I use OBS and Lioranboard to have just a little bit of control, and I hope this was helpful. If you have questions, it was kind of quick. If you have questions, please jump down to the Discord, jump in the technology section or general, or jump in and just private message me. I would gladly help you set this up or brainstorm ways to help you out. Make sure you check me out on Twitch. Again, I stream 3 days a week. I'd love for you to stop by. Ask me questions there. I can help you set up stuff on stream. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Ring that bell for notifications and give me a thumbs up, as it really helps out the channel with all of the wonderful YouTube analytics stuff. And yeah, with that, I'm Cyrus, and welcome to the darkness. We'll catch you next time.